Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we'll discuss rectangular hyperbola and asymptotes. First of all, let us discuss rectangular hyperbola. Now, we know that the standard equation of the hyperbola is x square over a square minus y square over b square is equal to 1, where a and b are the constants, and here the length of the transverse axis of this parabola is equal to 2a, and the length of the conjugate axis is equal to 2b. Now if a is equal to b, that is, if the lengths of the transverse and conjugate axis are equal, then the hyperbola is called the rectangular hyperbola. And its equation is, that is, by putting b is equal to a in the equation of this hyperbola, we get x square over a square minus y square over a square is equal to 1. And this implies x square minus y square is equal to a square. Now let us discuss the eccentricity of the rectangular hyperbola. Now we know that if E is the eccentricity of the hyperbola, x square over a square minus y square over b square is equal to 1, then E square will be equal to 1 plus b square over a square, and this implies b square is equal to a square into E square minus 1 the whole. And we also know that the eccentricity of the hyperbola is greater than 1. Now b square is equal to a square into e square minus 1 the whole. But for the rectangular hyperbola, a is equal to b, that is, for rectangular hyperbola, therefore, replacing b with a in this equation, it will be a square is equal to a square into e square minus 1 the whole, which implies a square over a square is equal to e square minus 1, which further implies 1 is equal to e square minus 1, and this implies e square is equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2, and this gives e is equal to root 2. As e is greater than 1 for hyperbola, therefore e is equal to minus root 2 is not taken. So the eccentricity of a rectangular hyperbola is equal to root 2. Now let us discuss the parametric equations of rectangular hyperbola. Now if x and y are both functions of another variable safety, that is x is equal to f of t and y is equal to g of t, then these equations are called parametric equations. Here the third variable t is called the parameter, that is t is the variable parameter. Now the equation x square minus y square is equal to a square, which is the equation of rectangular hyperbola, can be transformed to xy is equal to c square, and let this be equation A, where c is a constant and c square is equal to a square plus b square by 4, which will be equal to a square plus a square by 4, as a is equal to b in case of rectangular hyperbola. So this is equal to 2a square by 4, which is equal to a square by 2. Now x is equal to ct and y is equal to c by t will always satisfy the equation A, that is this equation, as ct into c by t will give c square for all values of t. Now as ct, that is x is equal to ct and y is equal to c by t, will always satisfy the equation A, that is this equation, therefore we can say that the point ct c by t lies on this hyperbola. For all values of t, therefore x is equal to ct and y is equal to c by t are called the parametric equations of the rectangular hyperbola. Now let us discuss asymptotes. Now an asymptote to a curve is the tangent to the curve such that point of contact is at infinity. Or in particular, asymptote is a straight line which touches the curve at plus minus infinity. Now consider a point P on the hyperbola, and you can see that as P on the curve moves farther and farther away from the origin, it may happen that the distance between the point P and these fixed lines that is on this side, this fixed line tends to zero. And this fixed line is called an asymptote. And on this side, this is also the asymptote of the given hyperbola. That means this fixed line will touch the curve, that is the hyperbola, at plus minus infinity. Now let y is equal to mx plus c is the asymptote of the given hyperbola. X square over a square minus y square over b square is equal to 1. That is, here we will see how to derive the equation of the asymptote of the given hyperbola. Now let this be equation A. So putting y is equal to mx plus c in the equation A, we get x square over a square minus mx plus c whole square over b square is equal to 1, which implies, that is, on solving, this will give 1 over a square minus m square over b square the whole into x square minus 2mc over b square into x minus c square over b square plus 1 the whole is equal to 0. Now, the line y is equal to mx plus c, that is the asymptote, touches the hyperbola, which is given by equation A, at infinity, that is, the roots of the equation, which is the equation B, are infinite. This means the coefficient of x square and the coefficient of x in this equation is equal to 0. So putting the coefficients equal to 0, this implies m is equal to plus minus b over a and c is equal to 0. Now putting the values of m and c in y is equal to mx plus c, we get y is equal to plus minus b over a into x plus c, which is 0, which implies y is equal to plus minus b over a into x. And these are the equations of the asymptotes of the given hyperbola. So diagrammatically we can see that these are the equations of the asymptotes of the given hyperbola, whose equation is x square over a square minus y square over b square is equal to 1. So in this session we have learnt about rectangular hyperbola and asymptotes. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.